Hi everybody, this is Angie from Tourangie.com, and today I'm in Bluefield. I just turned right on Bluefield Avenue, and I'm going to take a right just up here, just in case you haven't seen Sacred Heart Church in a long time. I want to just do a little turn up by there off of Wyoming Street, and one day I'll do the drive all of Wyoming Street to Union Street, but that'll be another day. I'm just doing a quick show of this. And I'm going to do a turn, go down a couple other streets over here, and come back out on Bluefield Avenue. And then the rest of the video is just going down Bluefield Avenue and taking a right at Midway, go through the Midway Tunnel, and then a left on Hale Street. I had a request for Hale Street, and I wasn't quite sure what I was getting into. So I did chicken out about halfway through it. The request said would like to see me go through Hale Street and the culvert. And I always assumed that the culvert was, you know, Midway Tunnel. But I believe there is another one, and it's on the Virginia side. And I don't know, the road just, it did not feel good for me to keep going. Now, it's probably fine, and I just don't know any better, but I am a little bit of a chicken at times when I'm driving and don't know where I'm going or what's going on. So, anyway, I've got part of Hale Street for you, and then that's about it for this video. So, at least you'll get to see a good bit of Bluefield Avenue and, of course, the Midway Tunnel and a little bit of Hale Street, which you will see a cute little deer. I hope my camera picked it up. Today's talk is going to be about music, and it's very long, so it will be split up between several videos, I'm sure. But we're going to try to narrow it down to Bluefield. I may mention Princeton just a little, but not much. Few families in Mercer County before the Civil War owned pianos or organs. The first piano in Princeton was ordered from Baltimore by Dr. Robert McNutt. Now, you all remember the Dr. Robert McNutt house there below the courthouse. It's been featured in several of my videos of the Princeton area. In the 1890s, the young people of Bluefield began the troop to the home of Ash M. Prince, who was a former mayor of the city, where his niece, Miss Gertrude Watts, had hung a shingle as an instructor in piano and voice. Miss Watts, a graduate of music schools in Virginia, Kentucky, and New York, was pleasantly surprised by the enthusiasm and latent musical talent aroused by her adventure. One of these small music enthusiasts was James Elmer Brown, who would awaken Miss Watts in the early hours of the morning in order to practice on her piano before the school bell rang. The community paid tribute to Miss Watts' ability by inviting her to act as an organist and choir director in Bland Street Methodist Church, one of the early churches to give music a prominent part in its service. This position was more of an honor than an economic asset. Ms. Watts has since been organist and choir director in Grace Methodist, First Baptist, and First Presbyterian churches. The first music club in the history of the city was organized by Miss Watts in about 1900. The club composed of local musicians who met occasionally for discussion and impromptu recitals. A woman's organization devoted to the study of history and appreciation of music was formed in 1911 with Miss Watts as secretary. The Music Culture Club, organized in June 1930, through group effort and enthusiastic leadership, has given the citizens of Mercer an opportunity to enjoy a series of civic music recitals. The Cooperative Concert Association, under the sponsorship of the Music Culture Club, has in late years secured performances of top rank artists from opera and concert stage. Memberships in the association, upon the payment of annual dues, entitled the members to attend all concerts presented during the season. Music received another fortuitous boom in Bluefield in 1904 when Alan McFowell, a violinist, and R. Blind Owen, a pianist, two members of the English Dairy Stock Company, which had been presenting light opera at the Old Elks Opera House, deserted the troupe and remained to open a studio in the Elks building. Owens fulfilled the conventional picture of a temperamental artist. His gestures at the piano, his unruly hair and casual flowing cape, amazed and entertained unsophisticated Bluefield audiences. Underneath the show of temperament was a rich vein of talent, upon which growing cultural life and city drew heavily. James Elmer Brown, the prodigy of Ms. Watts' piano school, became an admirer. When Owen organized the Choral Society in 1905, young Brown, then a lad of 15, was able to play the accompaniments. Mercer's first music festival, held in Bluefield, May of 1906, was organized and directed by Owen, who secured well-known artists from Cincinnati to perform in the concerts. The celebration was climaxed by the presentation of Gilbert and Sullivan's tuneful light opera, HMS Pinafore, which scoped a tremendous success. Owen removed to North Carolina shortly thereafter, and without leadership, the festival did not repeat the following year, much to the regret of the county's growing musical audience. So, in 1907, Owen's place was filled by Vincent Paleo, and I'm sorry, I'm mispronouncing that, P-A-O-L-I-E-L-L-O. He was originally from Naples, Italy, and was reared in Washington, D.C., and later Lynchburg, Virginia. He was en route to Cincinnati, but a friend persuaded him to stop in Bluefield for overnight, and the ticket to Cincinnati was never used. He opened up a violin class in his boarding house on Rogers Street, and 3 years later married Miss Minnie Mann of Bluefield. Earlier we talked about James Elmer Brown. He returned from North Carolina in 1909 after completing his study under Owen, and a studio was opened in the Union Bank and Trust Building, and Brown gave his first music lesson in his hometown and helped organize the Bluefield Music Festival Association in 1910. So we're going to stop there, because here we are at Midway Tunnel. There has been some developments. It was a few months back, but I want to read you an article about what's going to happen here with Midway Tunnel, if you all haven't heard. Let me read that to you now as we move on to Hale Street, where I chicken out in the video. But once I turn up Hale Street, I don't go very far, you'll end up seeing a deer cross the road. So be on the lookout for that. Let me read this article to you. So this was on December 7th, so it's been a while back, but the article says, today U.S. Senator Shelley Moore Capito, ranking member of the Environment and Public Works Committee, announced a $13,480,000 for construction of a new overpass bridge and road improvements in Bluefield, West Virginia. The funding is through the Rural Surface Transportation Grant Program, which Capito championed and included in the Infrastructure Investment and Jobs Act. When we wrote and negotiated the Infrastructure Investment and Jobs Act, I fought to ensure the transportation needs of West Virginia rural communities were taken into account. Today's funding announcement is welcome news and will ultimately help both residents and visitors who are traveling in and around Bluefield and the surrounding area. This is the kind of core infrastructure project we intended the IIJA to support, and I'm looking forward to seeing it constructed and completed. That's what Capito said. The project details include will construct of an overpass bridge to make road improvements on the approach to an intermodal facility. The project will replace an existing one-lane signal-controlled railroad underpass, Old Bramwell Road, County Route 11, Midway Tunnel, with an overpass that includes separated pedestrian and bicycle accommodations. So, not real soon. The grant is, you know, it was just announced that the grant was basically received in December, and it takes a long time for that to, the grant to be read through and everything else. But eventually, Midway Tunnel will be no more. There will be a bridge. So, I hope you have enjoyed this crazy little road I'm going. It's Hale Street. It's right up against, and see, I stopped several times because I'm trying to pull up my Google Maps just to make sure that I'm, you know, that this road does come out. I just felt very I chickened out. That's basically what it is. But right over there to the left, turn to the railroad, and then there's other houses and stuff up here, but I was really concerned on where it was going to come out at. And I keep going for a little bit further, as you can tell by the way that this video is, but this is Hale Street, and someone had mentioned that they had wanted me to see see me go through the culvert on Hale Street, or at Hale Street. I assumed the culvert was Midway Tunnel, but after I backed out, because I did, I end up stopping up here, and I just turn off the camera, and I back out into a driveway and turn around, because I don't go any further, because I chicken out. But if you go down, get back on Bluefield Avenue, and you go down to where Swift Mart is, there is a little road on the right, and I believe that may be the culvert they're talking about. The satellite image and the Google image of this road past where I turn around does not look good. It looks like big gaping holes and the stuff, like mud. And maybe it's just I was too much of a chicken and should have just kept on going, but I don't have the right type of vehicle to go mud bogging. So, sorry about that. This is about where the video stops. So this is Angie from Tourangie.com. Come to my website, read my blogs, and make appointments so I can help you plan your next travel adventure. I hope you liked this little video, even though I did chicken out. Talk to you later.